We're in our final leg to get to Miri today, and look, the crowd is of like-mindedness. Oh yeah, sorry, Mulu. And it says, Mass Wings Rural Air Service. Yes, that's how ghetto things would be. Okay, here's a funny thing, it's 9 o'clock exactly. And the clocks in the airport here at three different times. Three different clocks with three different times. This one is 9:13, and the next one is 9:08, and then the last one, I'm not sure if you can see it, is 9:15. They all don't match. Hey dear.
Hey.
How's it going?
Good.
We're gonna be loading on this plane from the back. Well, I guess they don't care about what boarding zone you are.
No.
You just get on and kind of like a bus. Right? Are you excited about the next leg?
Yes, sir.
Yes, we're going to Mulu. Yay, we're about there. Half an hour flight. And we'll be back. Catch y'all later.
Moss Wings has the best snacks because they serve Milo on board. This drink is quintessentially Malaysian, so props to MAS for this. And yes, pun totally intended.
Oh yeah, this is the best, man. Thank you. Have a good one, thank you.
Made it.
Yes. I like this plane. And we're here at Mulu and gonna be going to the big caves later on. We're gonna check in first. Later, guys.
This has got to be the smallest luggage claim area in the galaxy. They could have just substituted that short ramp with a table and be totally done with it.
Well, we just got here to Mulu National Park and we've checked into our rainforest lodge called Nanas, which is pineapple. It's pretty nice. I like it. We were kind of hoping to get a bungalow, but it was full. So we decided, hey, they have a treehouse thingamajiggy over there. I'm not sure if you can see it. But anyways, it's really well shaded, as you can see, and the building is nice. Look at that. This is our whole unit. It's like traditional carvings. Iban, I guess, or Karazan, I'm not sure who did it. But here's the room, let's do a little quick tour. Right here. Yeah, this room comes with two twin single beds. Air conditioned, bathroom in there. This is the rest of the other buildings. There's tons of rooms. Oh yeah, the important thing to show you guys is probably the bathroom. You probably want to know what it is. It's really nice though. It's new, refurbished probably, or just brand new-ish, like nice bidet. Look at that sink. Oof, that's a okay. And here's the shower. It's not like your typical Malaysian bathrooms where it's shared with the potty and everything gets wet over there. So it's separate. There it is. And if you want it open air right here, if you like people to watch you shower, sure, why not? Let's do it. Ah, the sound of the forest. Oh, there's a butterfly. We're definitely in the rainforest now. This is our cabin again. I'm gonna talk about the rainforest lodge. This one runs 265 ringgit compared to the bigger one. The biggest one that they have, the poshest one, is, well, besides the longhouse, it's like big groups of, I think, 15 and above people. But the bungalow runs 305 ringgit or something. This runs 365, two double beds, as opposed to one king bed and the other one or something like that. But this is newer. This looks so much nicer. I think they recently refurbished it. So it's really a good deal. It's a really good deal if you can get it. This place packs up pretty fast, even though they technically call it off-season. But they're full, so for whatever it is. But it's a great place. Come on by and visit. What's your first impression of Mulu National Park?
It's like being in a jungle.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
Lots of different butterflies, lots of green.
Yes, yes. It's too green.
2 grams.
Yes. I'm getting green color burn in my retina. Yes, can't see any other colors. Next thing on our agenda is Deer Cave. And what else? What cave?
Lang
Cave. Should be pretty sweet. The largest cave opening in the world.
This is Lang Cave, the smallest of all the show caves, but the formations in here were amazing and are still actively growing. It was a 3-kilometer walk to Lang with our guide. But you should probably be aware that almost all the destinations in Mulu National Park are guided tours. Kimberly and I are used to hiking freely at places like these, but we can see the pluses with having guides because they keep graffiti, trash, and wildlife destruction in check while supporting their own families. Quite literally next door is Deer Cave. This thing holds the title of the largest cave passage in the world, which you'll see in a second. It's breathtaking in size, beauty, and in stink. Well, let me clarify, the cave is not stinky by any means, but your nose will recognize that familiar odor as you pass the massive piles of guano. And speaking of which, if you notice the large black spots on the ceiling, those are bats, all 3 million of them.
Abraham Lincoln, check that out.
And just to give you a sense of scale of the massiveness of the space, look at those tiny people in the distance. And how large is this space, you say? How about more than 400 feet tall and 540 feet wide? So that's big enough for a 747 to fly through.
Very nice. These are what break down the guano and the dead bats. Honey, how do you feel?
Hot.
Is it hot?
Yes.
Oh boy. Yeah, I'm sweaty too, but look at that view. Isn't that amazing, guys? We're waiting for eventually the bats will come up.
The tour ends towards the evening to coincide with the daily bat feeding. All 3 million of them empty out that space in 2 to 3 hours, and it's really cool to watch because they come out like ribbons like these, and it's just, you know, it's so cool. It's just one of those rare natural events that happens in very few places on Earth, so it was really special to see it in person.
So this is mee goreng, mamak style, so we'll see how it goes. It's got a good bite, it's fried really well, and it tastes more like fried rice. That's okay, I like it, it's not bad in any way. And it's spicy, so that's good stuff.
That looks like cucumber.
Uh-huh.
Okra?
And, that's okra, yes, correct.
What's this?
Tofu.
Tofu.
And that's just, yeah, that's just regular, and that's Chinese cabbage, I think. And chicken satay. I don't know about that one, but that's the peanut sauce for dipping the satay in there.
That's spicy? I think that might be.
You can try that. Just give that a try. I think you should be okay. You know if it's spicy?
That little bit, it's okay.
Yeah. Again, you're happy there's a lot of vegetables?
Yes, I'm happy that there's vegetables.
Because Malaysian food...
I wouldn't necessarily call it a lot of vegetables.
Yeah, Malaysian food is not heavy on greens, and it's high in carbs, and low in meat.
As we see, the meat with my dinner.
Yes. I hope it's good.
The next morning, we took a long boat up the Fern River, and we were heading for some adventure caving at a place called Racer Cave. Wait, hold on a second, why is that guy faster? I want to be in his boat. Well, if you're ever there, take a long tail, because ours was slow as crap. On the way up the shallow calm waters, we passed by a couple of indigenous Dayak villages, where some of the employees of the park live. And people here are super friendly, so be prepared to wave a lot to kids and adults along the river. I don't have any clips in here because many of them were buck naked taking baths along the beaches. So there you go. Joining the Razor Cave tour will set you back 165 ringgit per person, and it's something you could totally do if you like tight spaces, scrambling, a bit of rock climbing, and getting a little dirty. And by the way, the cave is named after racer snakes. So yes, you have to like tight spaces, scrambling, rock climbing, being dirty, and snakes. But we didn't see any while we were there though, so that kind of sucked, depending on your point of view. In general, it's a good idea to bring a waterproof backpack or a dry sack, grippy shoes, and plenty of hydration. You don't have to worry about helmets, harnesses, or strong headlamps because those are provided by the tour. On our Malaysia trip, I used a dry sack with backpack straps. It turned out great for any activities that had our stuff submerged in water, like when we're spelunking or kayaking or swimming. Hey, honey.
Hey.
You're on video again.
Yes, again. Hello.
Yes, hello. How do you like it?
Good.
Good adventure.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, we found some caterpillars having sex. Sex in the jungle, yeah! The brighter color one is the male. Track the female, of course.
That evening, right after a much-needed shower, and just as we were walking out the door for dinner, we were treated to some heavy tropical rain, followed by lightning and thunder. Sounds we almost never hear where we live here in California. Sad, isn't it? So, don't be embarrassed if that sound also makes you want to go pee. Just, you know, feel free to pause this. It's okay. We'll wait for you. Okay? We started off a jam-packed day 3 with the early morning forest canopy walk for 42 ringgit per head. Coming out this early in the AM is an opportunity to enjoy the trail and forest without other people around. Just the pure sounds of the forest. Yes, the weather is still humid, but a few degrees cooler, which helps. Now, the tour maxes out at 8 people, so it's not noisy, slow, or crowded either. So what you get to do is walk among the trees at 60 feet high on one of the longest non-destructive canopy walkways in the world, which runs about, I think, 480 meters. If you're afraid of heights or wobbly bridges, you'll probably still want to give this a shot because it's a once-in-a-lifetime experience, so don't spend all that time at the gift shops, please. Between the canopy walk and our cave excursion, we just had enough time for nasi lemak, local fruits, and orange juice for breakfast. But we also ordered lunch from the cafeteria to bring out on our caving trip, just in case. And up the river we went again. And this time on a faster boat, woohoo! The final caving trip we went on is called Clearwater Revival. We also wanted to go on one of the advanced level trips, but they had a guide shortage, which actually gives us another reason to come back next time. Anyway, compared to Racer Cave yesterday, Clearwater Revival is all about getting wet. Again, be sure to have grippy shoes with relatively deep lugs. They'll not only allow you to navigate the razor-sharp karst riverbeds and rocks, but also give you some bite in the slippery mud sections of the cave. You've been warned. For professional stone skippers out there, these stones were all flat. Awesome, right? And here, I am testing out my new waterproof phone case. Clearwater Cave definitely has clear water. Get it? Yeah, I totally have a future in stand-up. At the end of our trek in, we got to swim and dive in this large, deep, cool, and clear pool. We hung out there for probably about half an hour or so, which was totally nice of our guide.
Does it turn up good on your camera? Can you see?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Nice, dear.
Yeah, it's quite deep.
The return trek was just as fun because we got to swim in the water some more and even float down most of the way like a lazy river back to base camp. And before we knew it, it was time to say a sad goodbye to Mulu National Park. It was actually hard making our way onto the plane. Sniffles. Back in Miri, we stayed overnight at the 4-star Jinhold Hotel right across the street from the airport. Now, let me take you on a quick room tour. Here we are walking down the corridor and we press the doorbell button right next to the do not disturb and house cleaning indicator lights, and there are no door placards here. Inside there is plenty of dresser space with sliding full-length mirror panels like a library ladder. The furniture is trendy and fresh while not looking like they were trying too hard to impress. And there's a king-size bed in here, nice and comfy. We had his and hers double bowl sinks. The shower is in a separate stall with a rain shower head. And yes, the water pressure was awesome. No low flow crap around these parts. Jinhold Hotel also supplies a full amenity kit for two, a nice thoughtful touch. The toilet with bidet is in the opposite stall. Why, looky here, there's even a balcony for your plants, drying, wet swim trunks or yelling from. If you feel peckish, there are plenty of good restaurants and coffee shops down below, at least according to Yelp. We got a corner room so the view of the city and airport was fantastic, but just remember to close the curtains at night when you're doing the funky dance, because I'm quite sure the airport control tower can see right into this room. On the second floor, there is a mini golf green right there behind banana leaves. Then the 24-hour unheated infinity pool is, as you can see here, and a kiddie pool is right next to it. Ah yes. Is any fun? Let's get on. Ah. Okay. Hello.
This is what you get with it.
They also have a fully equipped gym with separate sauna for men and women, and even a free laundromat with washers and dryers.
Yeah, dryers.
Oh, a dryer too? Yep. Sweet mama. And washing machine.
Disposable underwear for men.
Disposable, extra comfort.
Yep. Zesty. Oh, that's a zesty pepper. Mango.
This hotel even has an open-air library, which is on the ground floor. At the hotel's amazing and cheap, especially in US dollars, in-house muck restaurant, we discovered a cool version of the Milo dinosaur drink called Milo Dinosaur Float, which is the standard ice-cold Milo chocolate malt drink topped with a healthy layer of Milo powder and a scoop of chocolate ice cream. Oh mama, what a way to cap the trip. Well, that's it guys for this video from Sarawak. Next time we'll be catching you from Terengganu. Thank you for joining me today. And subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Thumbs up if you like this video. And thumbs down. Thumbs down if this is making you dizzy. Well, I'm sorry you were just motion sick. You have motion sickness and all that kind of stuff. That's too bad. You can't get on ships or anything like that. Get on amusement ride, park rides. I'm sorry. Thumbs down. But anyways, see you next time. I hope you have a great day and do something nice for somebody. And God bless you. Until then, until the next video, I'll catch you later.